Hi everyone, I'm Jake. Welcome to Nature Beings. In today's video, I will be talking about an incredible health drink called kombucha. It's a completely natural form of probiotic. I'm sure some of you are already using it and some of you are absolutely ignorant about what is kombucha. Why is it even called kombucha? So after watching today's video, all your doubts will be cleared and you will start drinking it regularly. So guys, before we head into the video, just want to make a humble request. If you're new to my channel, kindly subscribe it and support my channel as I always upload incredible healthy videos. So in this video, I'm gonna tell you the various health benefits of kombucha and also how you can make your kombucha at home yourself. Because that's what I do. I brew my own kombucha at home. In fact, I'll just show it to you. So this is the kombucha bottle that I get from the market. And this is my home-brewed kombucha. Alright guys, so we'll come back to making it at home later. First, let's discuss about what is kombucha. Before you start drinking it, you need to understand the ancient history behind this incredible drink. Kombucha is an ancient beverage that originated in China more than 2000 years ago. In the year 221 BC, the tea of immortality, according to an ancient myth, the first known kombucha was invented by the Qin dynasty for the emperor Qin Shi Huangdi. It was called the tea of immortality or elixir of life. It used to keep the emperor young and healthy. Then again, in 414 AD, Dr. Kombu plus cha gives Japan a taste of the elixir of life. Kombucha adopted its name after a man by the name of Dr. Kombu. He brought the beverage to the Japanese emperor in Yoko during his travel. And the term cha means tea in Japanese was added to his name after discovering its enhancing property. The tea was said to give samurais a great deal of energy during battle. So that's why it's called kombucha, from the name of Dr. Kombu, and cha means tea, kombucha. So all I'm trying to say is that kombucha is not some new diet fad. It has been used in the ancient times as well by emperors and samurais to maintain vigor, strength and vitality. So that was about the ancient history of kombucha. Now let me tell you what actually is inside this drink. What is actually kombucha? So as the name suggests, cha means tea. It is made by using green tea, and you brew the green tea in water, add some sugar into it, and then add SCOBY. SCOBY is basically a short form for symbiotic culture of bacteria and yeast. This is what SCOBY looks like. This is basically a colony of bacteria, mostly lactobacillus. So when we put green tea and make sugar in it and put this active culture SCOBY inside it, SCOBY basically start eating the sugar and it start the process of fermentation, because of which a lot of acids are produced, gases are produced inside it during fermentation, and main thing which is produced is also acetic acid. It also contains trace amount of alcohol, somewhere around 0.05%. So by the end of the fermentation process, which is roughly around 10 to 15 days, if it's not a very cold weather, otherwise it can take more time, and the end result that we get is kombucha, which is a fermented green tea with active culture in it, and it also tastes a bit carbonated, but it does not have any soda in it. It's just because of the fermentation you get that carbonated feeling. So green tea is good for health and we all know it. The question is, why do we need bacteria stay healthy? And that's where I want to clarify something. And that is, in our gut, that is our gastrointestinal tract or our small intestine and our large intestine, we have colonies of bacteria, what we call our gut microbiome. And we have good bacteria and bad bacteria. I won't go too much into the detail of it. I'll make another video on gut health. For now, basically what happens when there is a dysbiosis or imbalance between good and bad bacteria in our gut, we start facing health problems and gut inflammation or leaky gut, which leads to other serious issues in our health, like type 2 diabetes, fatty liver, high blood pressure, gas and bloating, indigestion. All these conditions, they start appearing in our body because of only one issue, and that is dysbiosis in our gut microbiome, that is increase in bad bacteria and decrease in good bacteria. So basically, due to our lifestyle, like eating junk food, drinking soft drinks, too much sugary stuff, all these things, they increase bad bacteria. But unfortunately, due to sometimes, in some bacterial infection, we take antibiotics. I always prefer not to take antibiotics for simple things like common cold and all. And the reason for that is antibiotics basically kill bacteria. That's how they cure us of bacterial infection. Unfortunately, those antibiotics, they don't only kill bad bacteria, they also kill bad good bacteria. And that's where the problem happens. When the good bacteria's numbers start reducing and bad bacteria start increasing, we start facing the health problem that I mentioned before. So we need to create a balance in our microbiome again by introducing good bacteria. Bad bacteria we are anyways introducing through our junk food, but we need some food to increase good bacteria, and that food is called probiotic, what we have in kombucha. Primarily, kombucha's active culture contains lactobacillus, which are a strain of good bacteria. They help us fight bad bacteria in our intestine and start the process of healing our gut and reducing the gut inflammation. That's why kombucha was called elixir of life in ancient time. It provides the antioxidants of green tea and also the probiotic in the form of lactobacillus. Some of you might be using those capsule form of probiotics. I personally don't use them because I find them waste of money and total garbage. If you want probiotics, find a natural source like kombucha. So I believe now you're clear about the origin of kombucha, where it came from, and the nutritional content of kombucha, what is it made of. And now let's talk about the various health benefits that we get simply by drinking kombucha. So number one and the most important health benefit that we get from kombucha is it helps to fight oxidative stress. Oxidative stress is basically caused by attack of free radicals. Free radicals are reactive molecules. They steal the energy of our cells, make them weak, make them old, and then our cells die out. And that is one of the main reason why we start aging, start getting wrinkles on our skin, and our multiple organs inside our body start getting weaker due to oxidative stress. That is our number one enemy in today's time. And kombucha contains lots of antioxidant because it is made by fermenting the green tea, and green tea contains all these antioxidants and polyphenols like EGCG, that is epigallocatechin-gallate-3, which is so powerful. When it goes inside our body, it starts neutralizing all these harmful free radicals, and that's how we start getting this glowing and young skin, and our organs start regaining their health because our cells are able to retain their energy. Traditionally made kombucha with green tea have the antioxidant protection for our liver also. It helps to reduce toxicity in our liver. So you can also call it a liver cleanser as well. And remember one thing, once your liver is healthy, everything will go right for you in your body. Second important benefit of drinking kombucha is that it kills bad bacteria. So one of the main substances produced during the fermentation process in kombucha is acetic acid. And acetic acid has the potential to kill the harmful microorganisms. Kombucha has very strong antibacterial properties, especially against infection-causing microorganisms or bacteria and candida yeast. A lot of people have candida infection, and they can immensely benefit by drinking kombucha. Also, people who suffer from various allergies like sinus allergy and food allergies and skin allergies, they can benefit immensely by regularly drinking kombucha. In fact, the reason why I started drinking kombucha was because I had chronic sinus since last 15 years. And in my research on how to naturally cure my condition, kombucha, that's where I discovered about kombucha, and I've been drinking it for almost 1 year now. And it has immensely helped me in getting rid of my sinus issue. In fact, I made a video about it. You can check it here and watch. It is one of the most informational video about sinus allergy. And the good thing is these antimicrobial and antibacterial properties of kombucha, they only kill the bad guys, the bad bacteria. The good ones, the lactobacillus, they stay intact, and they provide all the benefits to us when we drink it. So remember, next time when you think about probiotic, think about kombucha. This is, in my opinion, the best probiotic. Third important benefit of drinking kombucha is it helps to maintain the healthy cholesterol levels in our body. Heart disease is the world's leading cause of death, and rat studies show that kombucha can greatly improve two markers of our heart disease, that is bad LDL and good HDL cholesterol. In as few as 30 days, even more importantly, tea, especially green tea, protects LDL cholesterol particles from oxidation, which is thought to contribute to heart diseases. In fact, green tea drinkers have a 31% lower chances of developing any kind of cardiovascular disease. And these same benefits can be attributed to drinking kombucha, since traditionally it is made by fermenting the green tea. But here you get the dual benefit. You get the antioxidants of green tea and you get the probiotic properties of lactobacillus bacteria. So I personally believe to maintain healthy cholesterol level, it's better to drink kombucha every day rather than taking any kind of cholesterol pills. Fourth important health benefit of drinking kombucha is that helps to regulate blood sugar level and also good for people who have type 2 diabetes. A study in diabetic rats found that kombucha slowed down the digestion of carbs, which reduced blood sugar levels. It also improved liver and kidney function. So those were the scientifically proven health benefits of kombucha. Now when it comes to anecdotal evidence, my personal testimonial is obviously I always tell everyone how much I have benefited by drinking kombucha, and I propagate it wholeheartedly. Alright guys, now I'm going to tell you how you can make your kombucha at home the way I do it. That's what I'm going to tell you. For that, what you need? A glass jar, and then you need a small breathable piece of cotton cloth, or even a coffee filter will work, because once you put everything inside, you have to cover it, put a rubber band here and then shut it, and that's it. So what you need is basically, of course, green tea of your choice. You can take around 3 to 4 cups of filtered water, and then make sure the water is filtered and pure. So put your tea for brewing. You can put around 3 to 4 tea bags of green tea, or if you want to put leaves, you can put the leaves. Once your tea is ready, let it cool down. After that, just add 1/4 cup of sugar, or you can put organic honey. I personally put organic honey. Stir it. After that, just add your SCOBY in it. SCOBY is your this colony of good bacteria. So this you can find online. I'll provide the link in the description where you can get order it, and it will be delivered to your house. So once everything is ready and is cold, put your SCOBY inside it and then cover it with the cloth, put the rubber band here, shut it and keep it in some dark place, like in a cabinet somewhere. I put it in my cabinet on top behind in my kitchen cabinet, and I leave it there for around 10 to 11 days. And after that, you will see that on top of your jar, this white color SCOBY has come up like a mushroom, which means that your kombucha is ready for drinking. Only one thing you have to be sure of: don't add too much sugar, because otherwise the alcohol content when it will increase a lot. Sometimes the home brewed kombucha alcohol content reaches to 3 to 4%, which is not good. It's better to stay in the limit of 0.05%, and that's why I told you add only 1/4 cup of sugar. Alright guys, so that was all about kombucha. Now you know what is kombucha, how to make it. I would say that get ready with your kombucha, start drinking it, and cheers.